this COVID-19 has brought much wear and tear in our life, starting from social life to the pattern of everyone's work lifestyle. The pandemic has taken not only many lives but has also brought some serious economy ravages like job losses, pay cuts and other bifurcations in the corporate structure. On one hand, where automobile, electronics, tourism and aviation, textiles, hospitality were injured at a larger scale, industries like pharma, chemicals, health and FMCG are playing the ball game perfectly. While the economy seems to be seeing the delay in its nurturing, our financial regulators like RBI and others are stepping up to quantify one of the most conquering factors that everyone is facing most, the cash crunch. It has become a regular course of action for the service sector people who are dealing with these losses. Therefore, let's check out some sorted out tricks to deal with the situations. Loan against life insurance policies. Logically, there is no loan establishment for term policies, but with some pre-specified limitations, a policyholder can avail a loan against additional life insurance plans, including endowment, money-back plans, and unit-linked insurance plans. A policyholder is liable to avail loans up to 85 to 90% with guaranteed returns, and the monetary value totally depends on the current value of the corpus and type of fund. Conditions that require for these loans that the policyholder must have paid premiums for at least 3 years, the loan amount then decided on the surrender value of a whole policy. The policyholder has to remember the fact that they will need to repay the account or the loan within the term of the policy. Loan against PPF account. This is the other way out to deal with your emergence of the cash crunch. By dipping into your saving funds, that is public provident fund account balance, by paying interest at the rate of 1%. Although it may look like a very low rate of interest, as you will have to forego the interest that you would have earned on the PPF loan account, the actual cost of the loan will be higher. Therefore, the actual cost of the loan will be the rate of the interest on PPF that you forego plus 1%. Interestingly, the interest rates on PPF gets revised on a quarterly basis. As the recent change incurred by the government reducing the percentage to 7.1% for the quarter ending June 2020, which effectively increases the rate of interest on PPF loan, amounted to 7.1% plus 1%. Although it may seem much cheaper than a personal loan, which can range from 12 to 18% per annum, always think twice before choosing this option, as this comes with several caveats, as you will see. Reason number one is the fact that you will lose out on the tax-exempt interest amount that you earn on a PPF. Second, this loan cannot avail if the policyholder haven't paid any earlier loans in full. Third, the amount of loan cannot exceed 25% of the amount that was available in the account at the end of the second year immediately preceding the year in which the loan is applied for. Fourth, policyholders can take the loan after the expiry of 1 year from the end of the year in which the initial subscription was made within the 5 years from the end of the year in which the initial subscription was made. Finally, taking a loan will have a negative impact on the compounding of tax-free interest received and consequently on the corpus. EPFO withdrawal. For a salaried employee, the central government has passed a provision that has allowed employees to avail non-refundable advances up to 75% of the outstanding balance or 3 months basic pay plus DNS allowance, which is lower for their employees' provident fund. The EPF outstanding includes the interest as well as the contributions of both the employee and the employer. The loan application process is online through the EPFO website and the process gets settled in 3 working days. Forms 31, 19, 10C and 10D check leave displaying your printed name or the first page of your bank passbook or a bank statement with your name along with the account number and bank IFSC code is all the necessary documents that required during the online application. Liquidating the investments. Least advised norm and only be done. If required as a last resort because an impulsive decision to liquidate has transaction cost, tax and total return consequences, so consider carefully your reasons for liquidating before entering sell orders. Always calculate the way involved in liquidating your investment. Evaluate your cost. If it is too high, it is better to look at the other ways rather than breaking your life savers like withdrawal from mutual funds, SIPs, PPF accounts, fixed deposits, as they will come up with some penalty implications. Go contactless during pandemics. There are some banks in the country which offers pre-approved personal loan facility like IDFC First Bank. There are several financial service providers available via online portals which help. The contactless approach means no physical meet with the bank's representative, not even for the name and initials on the documents, which is, by the way, the most considerable factor during this pandemic scenario. They provide a simple digitally applied method to get money credited directly to a bank account in a much short span of time, that is approximately 1 hour only. COVID special personal loan. While the world is already facing some higher risk currently in this life and death situation, there are some financiers ready to help you deal with your emergence by availing the special COVID-19 personal loan offers of up to Rs. 5 lakhs from existing borrowers. These loans are available for those who hold salary or pension accounts with the bank with an interest range of 7.2% to 10.5% per annum as against 9% to 24% for a regular personal loan. Although the COVID-19 situation has brought in acute financial hardships for countless people, but making difficult choices during such tough times can save us from bigger financial crises in the future.